What's up, guys? Welcome to my channel. So today I'm going to be talking about my favorite brunette toning formulations that I use on my clients whenever we are transitioning them from a blonde to a brunette, or whenever we are just wanting to add some subtle brightness to their already dark canvas. So first off, I'm going to talk about my client from the other day. She had about a level 4 natural base canvas, and she wanted to have more of a subtle brunette brown dimensional tone going throughout her base color. So what we did was we did a series of TZ lights all throughout her hair, focusing mainly on the front pieces, giving her that nice bright pop. And in order to make her that really pretty chocolatey brunette tone, we toned her in the bowl with Redken Shades EQ 6G and 6N, all equal parts. What I really love about the G series and Redken Shades EQ, when you mix that with an N, something that's neutral, it creates a really beautiful chocolate warmth. And with that contrast in between a level 4 and under, it creates just like a subtle pop of dimension, nothing that's going to be too bold just for the people who want that natural sun-kissed look within their dark hair. So the next formula that I'm going to be going into is where I transitioned a dimensional blonde into a dimensional brunette. So I'm gonna go over my low light formula that I used on her, and then also my all over gloss that we use to gloss her lighter pieces that we left behind. So going in with the low light formula, I used 2 ounces of 6NB mixed with 1 ounce of 6N. And then I also mixed that with 3 ounces of the processing liquid from Redken Shades EQ. Mixed that all together, and then that was her low light formula. And then for her toning formula that we use for an all over gloss, I used just a Redken Shades EQ 9GI all over, and I mixed that with equal parts with the processing solution. We left that on for about 10 to 15 minutes and then rinsed that all together. And that created this really beautiful dimensional brunette that has some of those lighter neutral pieces, still with a touch of warmth. But because her base color was more on the medium level of brunette, that really bright warmth complemented it beautifully and made her hair look absolutely stunning with that transition that we chose. So the next formula that I'm going to share is for brunettes that want to have more of a higher contrast but still want to keep their contrast warm. I personally think that if you're going to have a darker base, having a warmer blonde really complements it and makes it look more natural. There are ways that you can get around having a darker base and then having a higher contrast blonde piece in there that is more of a neutral or somewhat cooler tone, but I really love the way that warm blonde complement a really dark base. So for this formula that I'm going to share with you guys, I use 1 ounce of Redken Shades EQ in the shade 9GI, and then 1/2 ounce of Redken Shades EQ in 8GG. And having those two mixed together, the 8GG gives it that really beautiful gold, and then that GI kind of gives it more of a more subtle, lighter golden color. And it kind of, I think that GI series really makes a sheer blonde. Doesn't make it super gold, but adding that GG like really defines those golden tones that you want whenever you are creating that higher contrast, warmer dimensional brunette. And then I also mix that with equal parts of the processing liquid. So mixing that all together, and that's where you're going to get that beautiful espresso golden brunette. So this formula that I'm going to be sharing with you guys is for that client that wants to have that really high contrast look to their hair, and they want to stay away from those golden tones and keep it as bright as possible. I think that if you execute this correctly, it can look really beautiful. So here's my favorite formula for that specific client. Whenever I transitioned my client right here from an all over blonde to a high contrast balayage, I did a low light color. And with that low light color, we used Redken Shades EQ 5N and 6G. And adding that 6G again just helps you whenever you are transitioning a blonde to a brunette, that G can add in that little bit of warmth that will keep it from turning too muddy. So to measure that out for you for that formula, I used 2 ounces of the Redken Shades EQ 5N mixed with 1 ounce of the Redken Shades EQ 6G. And then altogether, I mixed in 3 ounces of the processing solution. Mix that all together, and that was her low light and base color. And then at the bowl, whenever we were toning the rest of the blonde that we left out, I used Redken Shades EQ 9V and 9GI, all equal parts. And then I mixed that equal parts with Redken Shades EQ processing liquid as well. I really love mixing in the GI series with the V series because having those two mixed in together, I feel like that V takes away any unnecessary warmth, making it really rich and bright. And then adding in that GI kind of brings it down a little bit, making it just slightly warm, which also creates that beautiful brightness whenever it is hit by the sun. And I feel like mixing those two together just creates the most perfect blonde. That's been one of my favorite formulas that I've been using whenever I want to create something neutral but bright. Okay, so those are my top favorite toning formulas when it comes to brunette toners. I added in also some transitional low light toners that you can use as well whenever you are transitioning a client from blonde to brunette. I really love using Redken Shades EQ whenever I'm doing that, mostly because I feel like whenever a client who has been blonde most of their life transitions to a brunette, it can be a little scary for them. So having that Redken Shades EQ to be the transition, I feel like is more gentle of a process whenever you're wanting to lift it out if they decide that they want to go back blonde in the near future. So it just kind of saves you a little bit of insurance and time for whenever you are having to transition them back to blonde if they decide that they want to go back blonde again. So I always do that first, and then if they decide they love the brunette and want to keep the brunette forever, that's whenever I kind of explore more permanent options, something that lasts a little bit longer. But I think that Redken Shades EQ executes everything so beautifully. I use that a ton whenever I'm doing my formulas, and it just always worked out for me. So for those of you that want more behind the chair tips, tricks, and education, feel free to follow me on my Instagram page. I share loads of my formulas. The formulas that I have been sharing with you guys on this video is also on my Instagram as well. You will find that over there on my Instagram page. So feel free to hop on over there and give me a follow. Also, I have created a workshop for you guys for people that are hairstylists and want to start creating reels behind the chair, at home, wherever you're at. Reels are so important to be able to grow your business on Instagram. So I've created a workshop for you guys that you are able to have the simple steps to be able to create a very successful Instagram page using the Reels option. So you can also find that link in my bio on my Instagram page if you want to take that course as well. I really hope that this video was super informational. You got some value from it. For the people that have been asking for this video for a while, sorry that it took me a second. I've just been doing so many other projects when it comes to anything hair related and education. But I finally found time today to sit down and create this video for you. So I really hope you enjoy. And if you did, feel free to give me a like and subscribe to my channel for more future videos.